This is Ann Convey and her husband, What's My Line panelist Bert Convey. This is TV star Carol Rossin and her husband, stage and screen star Hal Holbrook. This is singing dancing star E.J. Peeker and her husband, film producer Bob Zampino. And this is Loretta Clark and her husband, TV star Dick Clark. These four celebrity couples are here to play He Said, She Said. And now, here's the star of He Said, She Said, Joe Garagiola.
You made it. Good.
Oh, the lovely ladies are here.
Good. All right, I'm going to get right to it now. You see what happens. We're going to see if your husbands can recognize you by the stories you're going to tell us about your married life, right? And your husbands are backstage, and they can only hear us when we want them to, like this. Hello, guys. Would you press your buttons? Where's Hal Holbrook? There he is. All right. Good. How you doing back there?
Oh,
wonderful. Good, Bert. All right, now when you do that, we see you on the screen, and from now on, anytime you want to talk, you please press that button. Now, each of you is playing for a different married couple in our studio audience, and the winner's prize, a week's stay at a Holiday Inn. Now, I'm going to cut you off right now. I'll talk to you a little bit later.
Bye, Joe.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Well, you guys sound sad, too. All right. Bye-bye. All right, ladies, I'm going to give you a topic. I want you to come up with an association so personal when your husband hears it, knows it was you. Clues, one or two words. First topic. A sign that he's getting older. A sign that he's getting older. Look at E.J. Peeker.
Oh, there's so many of them. I don't know which one to...
Well, give us 8 or 10 of them.
Okay, well, every morning he looks in the mirror and he says, oh, gosh, another gray hair. He has very, very dark hair. He's got these long, scraggly gray things right at the temple, and he's had them ever since I've known him. But he thinks that he's getting older, so I would say, Temple's graying.
Temple's graying.
Yeah, he's very funny about it. He keeps saying, hey, bring home some of that Clairol stuff, what? And I'll put it on me.
What are some of the other signs? Because I have that problem, too.
You do? Graying. You don't. I'm nearsighted, but it doesn't look like it to me.
What do you mean, Loretta? Why are you laughing? I got a lot of gray hair up here.
Yeah?
Sure. What are some of the other signs?
All right, I would say... Paunchy belly.
Paunchy belly. Yeah. That's anybody. Yeah. That's any man.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, no. You see, he's all muscle. He shouldn't have a paunchy belly.
Okay.
And I'm always teasing him about it.
All right. Well, let's use paunchy belly. See if the other guys go. Want to? Huh? What do you think, ladies?
These other guys are skinny.
No, are you kidding?
Let's try it.
How's
try it.
Dick has a big tire.
Do what? What?
Use paunchy belly.
All right, paunchy belly.
Okay, let's use paunchy belly instead of Temple's Green. All right, let's move ahead. Okay, Carol, sign that he's getting older.
I was going to say paunchy belly, but there you are. Well, in lieu of that, my husband, because he's played Mark Twain and did it when he was very young, has always thought that somehow or another, when he really had wrinkles in his face, then he would have character.
Uh-huh.
Now he has some, you know, lines coming in, and he's really sick to death. And
yeah.
Here you are. He waited all those years, and then now it's happening. So
what are we going to use?
For real lines.
For real lines. Okay, we've got that. Let's see who was next. Ann Convey, sign that he's getting older.
Well... You see, when I met Bert, he had these two cute dimples.
Uh-huh.
And now they go all the way down to here. So.
Sagging dimples?
No, not sagging. Paunchy dimples, no.
Paunchy
no, they're not
dimples.
No, they're not sagging. They're lengthening.
Lengthening?
Yeah. That ought to get him.
Is that going to be your clue?
Yeah.
Lengthening dimples.
Yeah. You'll hear it steaming back there.
All right, we've got three responses. Loretta, you don't get to play, but you're sitting there like the cat that ate the canary.
Well, you wouldn't believe, you know, what I had to say. That's why I didn't say it. All these are true, plus I have to tell you one thing. He did a movie, or produced a movie, but it was a commercial one. With motorcycles and everything. And then one day Dick came home and he got these new blue Levi's. He's always so conservative, and he said to the housekeeper, throw these in the washing machine for 4 hours and keep pouring bleach on them. Then he bought a belt, big wide belt, and sprayed it with black paint. And he's got these flower pot boots, is the only way I can call them. And all of a sudden, he's walking around. He really looks terrible. His parents look at him. They can't believe it. And I think that's a sign of getting old, because he's trying to dress like the young motorcycle crowds or something. And it looks very funny. It's embarrassing to walk with him.
Flower pot shoes.
Okay, let's go backstage and see what happens. Hello there, backstage.
Hi. Howdy.
Hi. All right, now remember to press your button as soon as you recognize your wife. We said a sign that he's getting older.
God bless you.
Bless you.
Wait, Bert Convy says God bless you up there. Somebody sneezed. That's a sign somebody's getting older up there.
Just because you sneeze doesn't mean you're getting older, does it?
No. Okay, guys. We'll start over again. I said a sign that he's getting older, and she said paunchy belly.
I told you he was.
Dick Clark. Whoop, oh, here comes Hal Holbrook.
It is not I.
Well, you were first, Dick.
Paunchy belly.
Beg your pardon?
Yeah, you were first. A sign he's getting older, and the response was paunchy belly, and you just rang.
Every now and again, there may be something else, but it is certainly one of the problems. Every now and again, she'll grab me, like, here and here, you know, and go, with the talons and say, ha-ha-ha. And I'm afraid that's not me, and I want to go home.
Well, Dick, it wasn't Loretta who said that. I'll have to take 10 points from you. Bob Zambino.
What?
Yeah!
All those ravioli.
Oh, come on. I'm talking about it. I don't have a paunchy belly. I just lost it.
Well, with what E.J. told us, I'll have to take 10 points from you, Bob.
Are you going to ask the same question about the girls like that?
Yeah, all right. We'll do that at your request, if you'd like us to.
Hands down.
Okay, you think about it. All right, we set a sign that he's getting older, and she said, for real lines. Bert Convy.
Well, that could be me. I don't know how a 25-year-old can have lines in his face. But
I don't know, Bert, why don't you ask one somewhere?
Okay, Dick, do you have 25-year-old lines? I guess I have what you might call a little tiny, teeny crow's feet around the eyes. Mm-hmm. And I used to have a couple of dimples here that are kind of becoming elongated into lines, if that's what she's referring to. Am I wrong?
You know, it wasn't. No, she didn't say for real lines. Ann didn't say that. I'll have to take 10 points from you.
It's worth it if she didn't say it. Thank you, dear.
Hal Holbrook. We thought you were.
I didn't press my button.
Why?
Aww. Well, somehow I didn't think my wife would say that. Although it's true. Maybe that for real part. I've been sitting here thinking whether she would have said that, and that for real part kind of gets me because of doing that old makeup for so long. Well, I guess it was me, right?
It was, and we'll have to take 10 points because you didn't recognize that. Okay, we set a sign that he's getting older, and she said lengthening dimples. Bert Convy.
Well, if that's not me, then I've missed a couple of dimples on the panel here.
Now that you've made it sound worse than it is.
Yes, right. Lengthening dimples is a much nicer way of putting it. I'll accept that. Thank you, my dear.
That's what she said. 25 points for you, Bert. Very good. More of He Said, She Said in just a moment. Right now, this message.
Happy Valentine's Day from Buzzer.
Now, ladies, I have a new topic for you. And I'm kind of anxious to hear this one myself. The first time he kissed you.
Oh, I remember.
You remember, huh? I hope, for his sake. All right, DJ. Okay. The first time he kissed
you. Oh, gosh. All right, I'll tell you something. I had a tiny little studio apartment on the west side, and I loved it because it was the first time I was furnishing things with my own money. And the greatest thing that I fell in love with it because it had a big walk-in closet. And I remember I was saying, oh, Mr. Zampino, this is my, you know, my kitchen set. And so I was walking around, and I said, I've got to show you this, my walk-in closet. And I walked in, and I turned around to talk to him, and he grabbed me and kissed me. Ah. So all I can say is walk-in closet.
Walk-in closet. Sure, you would remember that.
I don't know if he would or not.
Oh, if he
doesn't. It was a long time ago. It was him.
Okay, all right.
I was. With that nose, how could I forget it?
All right, walk-in closet. The first time he kissed you, who was next, Carol?
I was in a taxi. We were doing a really rotten play together on summer stock, and we were being very professional about the whole thing and not getting involved or anything. We were being an actor and an actress doing our thing, and we got involved, and it was, and it was in a taxi coming from a bar to dropping me home.
So what's going to be your clue?
Bumpy taxi.
That's funny.
Well, because the taxi was going down one of those horrible New York streets in the summer, and he was trying to kiss me like this. So, I mean, there you
go. Bumpy taxi. Okay. All right, we've got your response. Loretta Clark, the first time he kissed you.
We were at a party. Actually, I wasn't with him. He was having a party at the end of a tour. I was traveling with a girl singer at the time. And I don't know how we got by the pool. I forgot that part. But anyhow, we were sitting by a pool, and I was sitting on his knee talking because somebody lost a watch in the pool, and they disappeared. And when I went to lean over to get a drink, I think, I would have my drink on the ground. It just kind of
Can you talk a little bit louder? Because I don't want to miss anything.
Well, I think that's about it.
Oh, is that it?
So you can say by the pool or something.
Pool?
Yeah, kiss.
Pool or kiss?
Lean over pool. I don't know.
I wasn't there.
Pool watch.
Pool watch.
Yeah, because we were supposed to be looking for a watch.
Okay. We were supposed to be looking for a watch. All right. Pool watch. We've got the three responses. Let's go backstage. Hello, guys. You all set to play? All right. Remember to press your buttons when you recognize your wives. We said, the first time he kissed you. And she said, bumpy taxi. Hal Holbrook.
Why, it was going from the Algonquin Hotel, and we caught a cab. We walked to Fifth Avenue and caught a cab, and we almost chewed each other to pieces. Because the cab was very bumpy.
That's what she said.
Nicked our teeth and everything.
We said the first time he kissed you, and she said pool watch. Dick Clark.
He remembered. Huh.
I don't know about the watch. Did you?
We were looking for a watch.
Oh, was that the excuse? I don't know what you thought about. We were at a party, and it seemed like a good idea to go outside, and allegedly there was a watch to look for or something, and it's, you know, the moon, and it was August or June or August, wasn't it?
Yeah, September 1st.
At 11:04, yes. No, it was by a swim pool at the Michigan State Fair. We were staying there for a show.
That's what she told us, Nick. We're going to give you 25 points. We said the first time he kissed you, and she said, walk-in closet. Bob Zampino.
Yeah, I think that was me.
You think it was me?
Yeah, I think the first time, the first week we dated, she had a huge walk-in closet, and walking out, she followed me in.
She followed you in.
Into the closet.
Sure.
Into the closet. Uh-huh. And that's when I got hung up on the smell of camphor. Well, anyway, it was her apartment, her walk-in closet. That's where I first kissed her.
That's a very exciting story, Bob.
Yeah. Well,
we're going to give you the 25 points. All right. We've reached the halfway point in our game. It's time you to change places with your wives. Would you come out on stage, please?
Promotional consideration furnished by National Airlines with nonstop service Miami to London. National says you're going to have a great flight.
Now let's meet the husbands.
And here they are. Here's Dick Clark. The Clarks have 15 points. Next is Bob Zampino. The Zampinos have 15 points. Here's Hal Holbrook. The Holbrooks have 15 points. And Bert Convy. The Convys have 15 points, Joe.
Okay, John, we're going to see how good the husbands are, or the wives are, recognizing the husbands in just a moment. But first, this message. On stage, we have with us Dick Clark, and the Clarks have 15 points. And this is Bob Zampino, and the Zampinos have 15 points. And this is Hal Holbrook, and the Holbrooks have 15 points.
Well, wait till you hear this score.
This is Bert Convy, and the Convys have 15 points. Okay, you guys are all backstage. Remember, you're each playing for a different married couple in our studio audience, and the winner's prize is a week's stay at a Holiday Inn. And guys, in the other section with the wives, we set a sign, you're getting older, I'm going to give you a chance to get even. The topic is a sign that she's getting older. God. Whoop, Bob is up there right now.
Pot belly.
He said it. He's in trouble.
Well, you know, if she could say I have one and I don't, then I can say she has one, even though she doesn't.
Okay. You look like, all right. Pot
belly. She's flying off the, you know.
Okay. Pot belly. Let's see who was next here. Dick Clark. A sign that she's getting older.
This is kind of a strange one, Joe, and I mentioned it to her yesterday, and I don't know exactly how to say this politely. When I first met her, she's a very, very shy person and wore clothes like up to here on the Adam's apple.
Uh-huh.
And she was showing me some of the things she might bring to wear on He Said, She Said, and I noticed that there was quite a bit that was exposed to the public, and the dresses are getting lower cut.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's either bosom exposed or low-cut dress. She's never did that as a kid.
Never did it as a kid.
And maybe it's just the style change, but...
You want to give me a clue?
Low-cut dress.
Low-cut dress.
Sis.
Is a sign... Dresses. It's a sign she's getting older.
I think she's getting more mature or something.
Okay,
she's not
right.
So bashful about it.
Let's go... Let's see here. Bert Convey.
Well, I had one, Joe, but I'm taking it back. No, if I say that, I won't be able to go home tonight. I think what I should say about, well, I don't even know if you'll accept that. I would say like vintage wine. She really is not getting older. It's mellower. How can I say that? It's better.
Well, that's nice.
Why don't you use the first one?
What was the first one?
I don't know.
No, never mind. Maybe Hal's got one.
Well, I can say, I have to kind of repeat, but I can say large tummy because she's pregnant.
That's a sign she's getting older.
Well, it helps, you know.
Okay, all right. We'll go backstage and see what happens. Hello, girls. Y'all set back there?
Yes.
All right. Remember to press your button when you recognize your husband. We said a sign that she's getting older.
They did it.
And when we said a sign that she's getting older, he said large tummy. Carol Rawson.
Well, I don't think that's fair. I don't see what that has to do with getting older. I'm getting pregnant is what I'm getting, but
mature,
I'm not...
Mature, dear.
Mature, yes. It's a mature baby is what it is.
That's what he said. We're going to give you 25 points, Carol. We set a sign that she's getting older, and when we set a sign that she's getting older, he said pot belly. E.J. Peeker.
Oh, no. He's been accusing me of gaining weight. And he just said the other day, he says, hey, and he didn't know what to say, you know. He says, I said, pleasantly plump. Is that what you want to say, pleasantly plump? And he says, no, just a little bit chunky. And so he said I was gaining weight in my belly, but I gained it all over. I have been. And I think that's what he said.
That's what he said. We're going to give you 25 points. We said a sign that she's getting older, and he said low-cut dresses.
You're terrible.
Loretta?
Oh, that doesn't mean I'm getting older. I wore them a long time ago, too. Always.
No. Tell the truth. You used to wear, like, steel corsets up around your chin.
Just a minute. Only last year and the year before, but before I met you, I used to wear a lot of low-cut things. And now I've decided heck.
It's going to be one of those days again, isn't it, baby? We all go home. Saw you on the TV, Dick, about your wife.
Yeah, about your wife. That's terrible.
That's what he said. We're going to give you 25 points, Loretta. Okay. Going to take two responses. Only two of you can play. Topic is her most endearing trait. Her most endearing trait.
No answers.
Bob Zampino.
I was going to say legs. I guess that's her most endearing trait. She's got great legs.
That's endearing.
That's endearing.
For you, it's endearing.
For me, it's endearing. For somebody else, it's, you know...
Okay, all right. Great legs. Okay, her most endearing trait. Hal.
She really listens to you, to me.
Really listens?
Mm-hmm. Tries to help, you know.
Uh-huh.
She's very good at it, too. She really listens and then, you know, to what I have to say, and then she really comes up with a good answer.
About everything, huh? Not just about your business.
No, about everything. Yeah.
Really listens. Okay, let's go backstage and see what happens. Girls, y'all set back there?
Yes. Yeah.
Press your button now and you recognize your husband. We said her most endearing trait. And when we said her most endearing trait, he said great legs. E.J. Peeker.
I don't know, but he always tells me.
Talk about humility.
No, because, you know, he just said that just the other day. He said,
hey, baby, you got great legs.
And he said it just like that, and that's why I remembered it. I don't know if he meant it, but he said, hey, baby, you got great legs and skinny ankles.
With a cigar in my mouth, right? Yeah.
But it's what he said.
Hey, baby, you're going to get 25 points. Okay, we said her most endearing trait, and he said really listens. Really listens. Carol Rossi.
I just listen. I mean, his pace is so different than mine. I'm a big city girl, and he's from the Midwest there, and it takes a long time. So in order for me to follow, I just have to really listen. Is that right?
Carol, that's what he said. We're going to give you 25 points.
That's funny. It didn't come out that way when you said it.
And girls, I just want to tell you there were two fellas who couldn't think of anything when we said her most endearing trait. Two fellas couldn't think of anything.
That's not true, girl.
Come on now, Joe.
Don't let him do that, Joe. It only takes two answers.
Final scores.
Got enough trouble, Joe.
Winners. The first is Messi.
Up next, diamond rings, candy hearts, and Joe Garagiola. It doesn't get more romantic than that. The He Said, She Said Valentine's Day marathon continues.
Our couples are all together. Johnny, who's the winning couple?
Joe, we have a tie with 65 points each. The winners are the Zampinos and the Holbrooks.
Good. All right. Bob, in front of you, you have a card.
I just dropped it down the floor.
Okay. Who's going to read it, Bob?
I'll read it. Mr. and Mrs. Chester Scarborough of Marlborough, Massachusetts.
Oh,
there they are. Okay, would you read yours, Hal?
And Mr. and Mrs. Harry Stern of New York City.
Congratulations to both couples. You've won an exciting week for two at a glamorous Holiday Inn of your choice in the U.S. or anywhere in the world, such as Denver, Colorado. Get the Holiday Inn habit and go!
And that's what we have to do. Bye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for He Said, She Said. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Get ready to match the stars. Joe Garagiola. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Forever Fernwood, Deborah Lee Scott. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Raver.
There's another ready out there.
Good. Are you ready up here?
Yep.
Well, you look ready to be.
Do you know
especially
what it was 1 week ago today?
What was it 1 week ago today? What?
My birthday.
Oh. A week ago today.
Yep. I told you never to mention your birthday.
Lady, you now have my disease. Thank you. Little kiss for you.
How old were you?
That's kind of the...
She's terrible. She's always telling her age. I have to hit her. It's a wonder she didn't tell her age. Well, I said, no, people always put 3 years on it. You know, if you say, I'm 28, they say, ha, 31 if she's a day.
I'll drink to that.
She is 31. Let's say hello to the current champ over here, Tennis Gray.
Hi, Gene.
Oh, hi.
Now, Tennis has $11,550. She will be playing for
$2,500 as soon as we are ready for her. Are you ready for that?
Yeah.
You could increase your winnings here by quite a bit. We'll do that right after we do this.
Unpredictable. Unbelievable. Unforgettable.
Are you an actor?
No.
That sure isn't the voice for it, is it?
Buzz Till Dawn, tonight, starting at 2 a.m. When you're up again, one too many times.
Makes you feel kind of stodgy, doesn't it?
Only on Buzzer. Let's play.
Hello there. Shall we carry on with Tanis Gray, who now has $11,550 and will be playing for 10 times the amount of money she won as we left the air yesterday, or $2,500. Now, to collect that amount of money, Tanis, you have to match one of our celebrities exactly, remember.
Richard.
Okay, good luck to you. Stand on that little blue dot and face me if you would, please. Here it is, worth $2,500. Good luck. Blank. Copy. C-O-P-Y. Blank copy. Blank copy. Okay, he's finished. Now you give us an answer that matches his. We give you a bundle of money. Good luck. What do you say?
Xerox?
Xerox copy. Two guys like it, the rest of you hate it.
Yeah, that was my husband that was clapping.
Your husband was clapping, hoping that he's going to say Xerox. Blank copy. She said Xerox. What do you say?
Oh, I said Xerox.
Xerox! Well, congratulations. Yeah. They all booed you. You know what? I think, Tanis, they all thought that you were going to say carbon copy.
Yeah.
Did you reject carbon copy? Did you think about it?
No, I sent Xerox to her.
You sent the message to her?
Yeah. Sure.
Well, I mean, that is really psi phenomena if I've ever seen it or heard of it. You have $14,050, and here comes your new challenger, Jim Golden. Hello, Jim. Another souvenir card for you. Stops. We're all set there now. You know Jim Golden, don't you, Tanis? You know this lady?
Hi, Tanis.
She's a rich lady, Jim.
Is she?
Yes. What do you want to tell us about Jim Golden?
Well, Gene, my name is Jim Golden.
You're Jim Golden.
Jim Golden. I almost forgot that.
Yeah.
I've got two children, Butch and Chateau, and one on the way. As a matter of fact, it started on the way here today.
What?
She's right down there, and it's down to five. I don't want to hurry you up.
You mean she really is?
Yes, she really is.
You have pain. Does it hurt? She's got a watch. She's timing her. You're timing
her. How far apart are they?
How far apart are they now? Every 5.5 minutes?
How far apart are they?
Now, wait a minute. Boil some water. Do something.
Bridget just said she's in golden time.
She's in golden time. I'll say she is. Now, listen, don't get too excited now. All right, let's get going. All right. I don't want to hear any more about the Jim Golden story. Your wife said, let's get going. Let's get going. What the hell's going on here, there? All right, Jim, A or B?
She said B.
B. B for
you must have
baby.
Been terrific when Lynn was born.
Yeah, terrific.
I don't know anything about babies, Mr. Rayburn. I hope she doesn't have it now.
Well, we'll figure something out, won't we?
Okay.
Muggsy said, I grew up in a neighborhood that was so tough, my pet parrot didn't say Polly wants a cracker. It said Polly wants a blank. Tough neighborhood.
Yeah.
Parents said, never said Polly wants a cracker. It said Polly wants a...
Got it, baby. I want to know how far apart those
5.5 minutes at this moment.
You're in good shape, hon, I think.
Yes. All right. Ready, Chuck?
He's writing a letter.
He's writing a
letter. Charles, that woman is in labor. Will you hurry up? Nothing can get him off his blank. not even a woman giving birth.
Maybe I want to see some excitement in the front row.
You will. Mugsy said, I grew up in a neighborhood that was so tough, my pet parrot didn't say, Polly wants a cracker. It said, Polly wants a...
gun.
Gun.
I said, Polly wants a fight.
Fight is a good answer.
I couldn't let down a woman in labor. Polly wants a pistol.
Pistol is one.
Get on with it.
Okay, one for him. Chuck?
It's goodbye to blankets and a bottles. Gun.
Gun. Two for Jim Golden. Said Polly wants a gun.
Gun.
Got it. Listen, would you stop applauding? Let the others applaud. You just sit there and do nothing. Richard?
Said Polly wants a gun now.
Four for him. Hello, Betty, honey.
I'm only doing this to stop that woman from applauding. Polly wants another Boyd.
Polly wants another Boyd. Polly's had another Boyd. How do you think she got that way? Okay, Jim, you got four. Yours will be along in a moment. Right now, we've got this message for you. Don't applaud! He rearranged the furniture, and now the John is in the blank. How do you feel, Mrs. Golden? Everything okay? You're between contractions? Folks.
Don't worry.
She's all right. Ready?
Speed up. Speed up.
We don't want to have any problems here in the studio because we don't have any boiled water. Now we're ready to go with Tanis Crate. Harriet said my husband has no taste. Tea. While I was on vacation, he rearranged the furniture. And now the John is in the blank.
The kitchen.
John is in the kitchen. Someone's in the kitchen with Dinah.
That's what I said, kitchen.
Sure it is. Come to the kitchen. What do you got there?
I'm so unnerved about that little girl and that baby. I said living room.
Living room. What do you say there, Charles?
I said attic.
In the attic. That would be an unlikely place for it and a dumb thing to do. What do you say, Deborah Lee?
Kitchen.
Kitchen. That's two for her. Richard.
Living room.
Living room. What
I've
do you say,
often
lady?
I've heard of a John in the bedroom, but I just see evidently
in the bedroom. So at this moment, the score is 4-2. And we go to round two. And Jim, you may have A or B.
Let's try B again.
Don't be nervous, Jim. A it is.
He's Everything's the coolest gonna be all one right. here.
The Washington lobbyist said,
yeah,
I especially like working with Senator Snort because he handles himself like a businessman. When you give him a bribe, he gives you a blank. Only two people play.
Oh, I got that.
Joe and Betty.
Oh.
Good for you. All right. All right. Joe's thinking about it.
He handles himself like a
businessman. You think about it, Jim? I'll read it slowly while he's writing. The Washington lobbyist said, I especially...
Wait a minute, Joe hasn't finished.
Well, he's writing. I especially like working with Senator Snort because he handles himself like a businessman. When you give him a bribe, he gives you a blank.
A receipt.
Receipt is good. One possibility is the word receipt, which is what Jim Golden just said. How you feel, Mrs. Golden? Okay.
I'll make her feel better. I said receipt.
Receipt. Okay. That's five for him.
That's six for him.
Six for him. Well, Tanis Gray, you got to go to work now. You've matched two already. You got four to go. Joe, you lay out, and you lay out. The rest of you, please respond to this. Wanda, the fortune teller, said, yeah. A pirate wanted me to tell his fortune, but instead of his palm, he wanted me to read his blank.
Do I
instead
play?
Instead of his palm, you play.
Oh. Pirate.
Quickly.
But instead of his palm, he wanted me.
Instead of his palm, he wanted me to read his
oh!
blank. Mrs. Golden is down there.
Mrs. Silver.
How many minutes apart now, Mrs. Golden? Still about 5.5. Have you got one now? No. Okay. Ready over there. Here we go, Tanis Grave. Wanda the fortune teller said a pirate wanted me to tell his fortune. But instead of his palm, he wanted me to read his blank.
His money?
His money?
Yeah. Oh.
You ever said a fortune teller read the palm?
Yeah.
Well, this is... Life is so difficult sometimes. You got to match everybody to stay in the game. She said money. Brett, what do you say?
I am the villainess. I said leg.
Peg leg. So that means Jim Bowden wins the game. What the rest of you have? Peg leg. Peg leg. Congratulations, Jim Bowden. Dan Redman. The best team in it. Tanis Grave. You're quite a champ.
Thank you.
$14,050 for this lady. There she goes. Don't applaud, Mrs. Golden. Cool it. Do what I tell you to. You ready?
I'm ready, Gene.
Is this her first?
Yes, that's her first.
Oh.
You guys are so cool, I can't stand it.
Me too. All right, now, Jim, not too long ago, we polled a studio audience. We said you write down your best answer to this. Blank glue.
Oh.
If you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. $250 for the second most frequent answer, and $100 for the third, and three of the six loonies will help you.
How about Betty?
How about Betty?
Yes.
Epoxy.
Epoxy glue.
Epoxy.
Richard.
Elmer's glue.
Elmer's glue.
Joe.
Joe, the third position is a difficult position.
Airplane.
Airplane glue. Okay,
I got airplane glue.
Epoxy glue and Elmer's glue, and at this point you have an option of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Let's go with Elmer's.
Elmer's glue. Let's go down there at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Sticks-like glue was an answer that that audience gave.
That's that from that old saying.
Another answer they gave is under the $250 response. Crazy glue. You know what, that stuff that sticks instantly and you never get your fingers apart once you use it. Last chance for Elmer's glue, slide it.
Elmer! Yeah.
Very good there. Now you got another $500. And you're going to play for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000. And to collect, you'll match one celebrity and the money is yours.
Baby needs new shoes.
Who do you call on? You have to choose one celebrity.
Oh, excuse me.
Yeah.
Richard.
All right, here we go. Stand on that blue dot. And good luck to you, Jim Golden. How do you feel?
Fine.
Good. She feels fine. Here it is. Blank Henderson. Blank Henderson. All right, Jim, give us the answer that Richard has on his card. We give you $5,000, which will buy a lot of diapers. Good luck to you. Blank Henderson.
Florence.
Say Florence. They're all with you. Florence Henderson, according to the crowd. Richard, what do you say?
I'm...
Now you got $5,600. Congratulations to Jim Golden. And while he's celebrating along with his wife, what's her first name?
Debbie.
Debbie Golden is very happy out there. Listen, Debbie, when you applaud and laugh, I see this big mass going up and down like that. It makes me very nervous.
Gee, yes. I have a suggestion.
Yes.
Could we get Debbie to go to the hospital?
Yes. How do you feel, all right?
Listen.
Listen. That's the baby!
You've had a boy and a girl. And a boy?
And a girl? And a boy. Quintuplets! Listen, we gotta do a little business with America. Hurry back and see what happens here after that.
Today's consolation prize is our first La Machine by Moulinex, the incredible food preparation system from France, like having a professional chef right at your side, and a warming tray, and a supply of Wagner fruit drinks made from natural fruit, bottled in glass, now new improved grape and new apple drink, Wagner fruit drinks for breakfast or snacks, and a set of mugs, and a supply of Coronation's new Cocoa Supreme Instant Hot Cocoa Mix, the extra rich cocoa for real cocoa lovers. Just add hot water, stir and enjoy. And a radio, and a supply of Baskin-Robbins ice cream. Enjoy delicious hand-packed Baskin-Robbins ice cream, your choice of 31 flavors that give you that 30 wonderful feeling. Here's Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much, Johnny Olson. Here we go. We got a brand new player now. Well, let's all welcome Lynn Wells. Applause. Thank you. Now, Lynn, we'd like to find out a little bit about you.
Hi, I'm an emergency communications coordinator.
An emergency communications coordinator. Now, what the heck is that?
We handle pursuits, police pursuits, put out crime broadcasts.
You put out crime broadcasts?
Yes.
Oh.
For the County of Orange.
You're an Orange County employee. Well, that must be an interesting job.
It is very, very interesting.
Where do you, I mean, you work in some town in Orange County?
Right. The main office is in the City of Orange, and we handle the communications for the 26 cities throughout the county and the Sheriff's Department.
Give us an example of a message you would send out.
All units and stations for Station 32, A211.
A211.
5 minutes ago at the 7-Eleven Market, Hester and Chapman.
Oh.
Suspect vehicle southbound.
Is birth of a baby.
Oh, yes.
We handle paramedics
also. Studio 33.
What's that?
We handle paramedics in hospitals also.
You do all that?
Yes.
Well, you're a very talented lady, Lynn Wells. Good luck to you here. You
Thank
may have
you
A
very
or B.
Much. I will take B.
You want B? B for Baker, B for boy. Gina said, it's tough being married to a practical joker. We have the only house in the world with a blanking toilet seat. Tough being married to a practical joker. Have the only house in the world with a blanking toilet seat.
The blanking toilet seat.
Remember, it's round one. Anything that comes into your mind.
The blanking?
Toilet seat.
Oh, it's blanking.
Blanking, right. ING.
I've got you now.
Ready? Come on, Charles. Yes. All right. He's writing an answer, Lynn. I'll give it to you. Gina said it's tough being married to a practical joker. We have the only house in the world with a blanking toilet seat.
We have the only house in
practical
the world
joker.
With a charging.
A what?
Electrical charging.
An
electric seat.
And, all right.
Electrically charging.
A toilet seat with an electric charge in it.
Yes.
A toilet seat with an electric charge.
904, Studio 33.
Yes. The man has severe burns on his posterior. What do you say?
I said a ringing toilet.
Ringing toilet seat. Sit down and ring a bell. Yes. Yes?
One of my wonderful children got one of those little apparatuses, and we had a laughing toilet seat.
Oh, wouldn't that be grand? You sit down, and the whole room starts laughing. They said, I laughed when I sat down. What do you say?
I never heard such quiet in my life.
I meant heating. It gets hot. It's a heating toilet seat.
A heated toilet seat.
Close.
Yes. Yes, well, no, one with an electric charge might get hot, but that would not be the idea. Hers actually electrocutes your bottom. Yes?
You're not well.
Musicaling. Musical.
A musical.
Sings to you.
A singing toilet seat. What do you say, Richard?
My sons really did get one of these from a joke shop. It is not a nice thing to do, a squirting.
Oh.
And was Governor Reagan surprised?
All right, Betty.
I said a rotating toilet.
Rotating. Very good. So there we are, Lynn. Now you know how the game goes, and we'll see how you go in a moment or so. But right now, this for you.
Up next, it's a buzzer double play as celebrity couples bicker and tell all, just like normal married people on Tattletales. Stay tuned.
We don't have time to do another question. We hope both of you will come back tomorrow. It may be difficult for you, but you'll figure it out somehow, right?
I'll be here, yes.
All right, you take care of that sweet lady. And Lynn will look forward to seeing you tomorrow, too, as we will look forward to seeing all of you. Dear friends and gentle hearts.
I'd like to know what kind of a baby she wants. I mean male or female?
What flavor?
What do you say? You want a girl. Have you got a name picked out? What is the name you've chosen?
Florence.
What is that?
Oh, that's Jennifer. My grandmother's name.
Florence.
I love that name.
Florence.
Well, Florence won $5,000.
Oh, that's right.
You know, that's right.
Did it for keep an open mind.
Tune in tomorrow. See what happens here in the medical center. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.